Hi, and welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour, and today we're going to talk about 7336, which is the core solution of Microsoft Link Server 2013 exam. It's the first exam in the communication MCSE. And I'm delighted to have Aaron Steele, who's a consultant with Microsoft Consulting Services. Now, Aaron, you work with us today, but you spend most of your time with customers.
I do. I get to go out and help customers implement Link, help them design it, help them implement it, really sort of figure out how it's going to work and sort of work best in their business.
So this exam really kicks off with IPv6. Now that's a topic I've been hearing about since I started in IT in the 90s. Finally, we're really testing on it and really expect you to know it. Why is that?
So Link 2013 is really the first product, first Link product that actually is fully IPv6 compliant. So it's one of those things where as you're implementing it and putting it in as your customers, mm-hmm. you need to understand that IPv6 space, that IPv6 structure, simply because it's a core part of the product. The product works across that full IPv6 spectrum, unlike Link 2010, where, in fact, the recommendation was to turn IPv6 off at the OS.
Okay. So talk to me about architecture. Now, architecture is something that's it's in a lot of exams and a lot of different products, but these exams are quite different than they were for the 2010 exams. We really front-load those architecture questions.
Sure. So most definitely, what happened is in the Link 2010 exams, we were really sort of concentrated in the first exam on configuring an administration mm-hmm. and in the second exam on architecture. In this one, we're really sort of combining that, and now we have architecture spread across both the exams for the Link MCSE,
yes.
or for the communication MCSE.
Yep.
And it really is, it's proving to your customers that you know how to architect, design, and implement the solution front to back, soup to nuts, core through voice through cloud.
Okay. You know, another surprising thing for me was web apps. Office web apps is a feature that I didn't expect being tested in a Link exam.
Yeah, so Office web apps is an interesting one. It was an addition into the Link 2013 sort of stack, simply because without it, you can't present a PowerPoint
really?
Within Link. It's a little uniqueness. You know, if it, in SharePoint, even if you don't have an Office web apps, you
yeah.
can still interact with documents. In Exchange, you can still interact with documents.
I can still email you something.
Right,
yeah.
But with Link, if you don't have the Office web apps platform, you simply can't share a PowerPoint.
Wow, I had no idea. So logs have been around for a long time, and certainly we've been testing them as long as tests have been around. Why is it so important to understand how to read a log? And isn't that sort of self-evident?
It sort of is, but really what we're getting to in the Link exam is not necessarily how to read a log, but it's the new interfaces that Link 2013 has to capture logs in this unified manner. In Link 2010, you had the ability to turn on logging on a server or on a mm-hmm. system, and you'd have to figure out where that communication was happening. In Link 2013, we introduced the unified logging service that can go out and capture logs on a scenario-based. And that's really what this exam sort of covers when it talks about logging. It's not necessarily talking about logs themselves. It's
yeah.
about how to capture these logs in that sort of central logging service mode.
Okay. Well, let's wrap up with high availability. Disaster recovery, data loss, all that sort of stuff. Those things are just supposed to work, right? So why do I have to know them?
Again, it comes back to that sort of architecture question. You need to understand how to architect a system to be most available and most resilient. And that comes down to understanding failure domains and high availability and mm-hmm. disaster recovery. Because if you don't understand those things and sort of what's the best practice and what's the requirement to maintain that high availability, you'll never be able to design a system to meet your customers' requirements.
Well, thanks, Aaron, so much for being here. I really appreciate it.
Thanks, Jay.
So we've been talking about 70-336, which is Core Solutions of Microsoft Link Server 2013. It's the first exam in the Communication MCSE, so go out and get certified.